Hey, what's up, guys? Wise24 here, and today we're going to be going over this week at Bungie 5-20-2021. So, this season, so far, we're only 2 weeks into it, and I'm really enjoying the heck out of it. There is a few little quirks, like the Iron Banner tokens. You're able to redeem them, but the fact that the new weapons, the two guns, aren't dropping from turning the tokens, and Bungie let people say you turn in 500 tokens and then 3 hours later they're like, oh, it's bugged, you can't get the guns. As far as coming out and saying it, that's cool, but they haven't done anything to address the fact of maybe refunding these tokens to people, but they might. So I'll hold my tongue on that for now. But just throwing it out there right now, it just kind of sucks. Vault of Glass is coming. As you guys know, it's going to be 2 days from now. You will need to be at least 1300 power to be at the cap for all the encounters. Or it's going to have the contest mode, so it caps you at 1300. So you can go over that. You can be 1320, but when you go into the raid, you're only going to be 1300 for the first 24 hours of the raid, which 1300... that's really easy to get to, guys. So very accessible raid this time around. Being that it's a one from Destiny 1 might be a contributing factor, but there's the belt for World's First, which is cool. They're also disabling the Star Eater scales for the first 24 hours of Vault of Glass. The team has discovered an issue where some abilities were being granted a bit more damage than intended. We don't want hunters to take this race like they did Guardian games, so we're pulling this exotic on a short time out. Plan ahead and make sure you have another pair of pants slash boots. We call them boots. I don't know why Bungie put pants there. To infuse to appropriate powers. So if you guys don't know what the Star Eater scales are, they're the new exotic boots for the hunters. So if you guys don't know what they do, you gain additional super energy from orbs of power you pick up. While your super energy is full, picking up an orb of power overcharges your super, causing you to gain a burst of healing when cast and a bonus to your super damage. So there must have been something to do with how much damage the super was outputting with these on. So they're disabling it for the first 24 hours. Moving right along, Professor Broman's going to be hosting a tailgate. So he's not participating in the 24 hours, which he did last raid because of medical and health issues. He just couldn't do it, which is understandable. You know, focus on your health first before video games, guys, honestly. But moving right along, he's going to be doing a tailgate. So if you guys want to check out all the POVs, he usually splits it into six different streamers. It's pretty sick. So if you want to see a bunch of different teams all at once, he's definitely the man to go to. Moving right along, they've got the Bungie rewards. Here's the Vault of Glass ring that you can get once you complete it. You'll still have to buy it, but it unlocks the ability to buy it once you complete it. Here is the raid jacket, if you guys are interested. Looks pretty cool. I love that Vex design, and it's a little bit on the outside there, but the inside's really cool. Then they go on to talk about crossplay. So crossplay was out for like a couple hours if you could get into Season of the Splicer when it first dropped. People were able to join other clanmates that were on other platforms, which was pretty cool, but they pulled it because it was a bug. It wasn't intentional. They're planning to ship this season 15, which is the next following season, but they're starting a beta next week. So anybody that wants to participate, it's going to be from May 25th through May 27th. You'll get a unique Vanguard Strike cross beta playlist. And you'll click into it just like a normal strike or normal strike playlist, and it'll just match you with anybody from PlayStation, Xbox, Steam, and Stadia. Also, any player who completes at least three strikes in the Vanguard Strike crossplay beta playlist will be rewarded with the unique star-crossed emblem, which looks pretty cool, actually. I like the design of this. There's still strikes, so maybe they'll count for the pinnacle too, which would be even cooler. Or they might even have their own pinnacle. They don't say that, but you'll be getting this if you do at least three of those strikes. Then they go over the new Prime Gaming Amazon Prime. You can if you guys already have it linked through Bungie and Twitch, you can redeem this. You get the Vigilance Wing, Book of Dead Exotic Ornament, Ravenger Ride Exotic Sparrow, and then a House of Light Legendary Ghost Projection, which, I mean, who cares about ghost projections? I've said that many times, but yeah. So they're going to continue bashing the bugs that they find. Here's a couple of them. Prestige activity will now reward pinnacle gear as intended. So this is next Tuesday. This is not live yet, but these are getting fixed. Completing 8 bounties for the Servitor, Splicer Servitor weekly challenge will now correctly reward pinnacle gear. So I've been doing that and I didn't even realize. I just thought I was getting like really bad RNG. So that sucks. Energy Accelerant will no longer increase damage against players. Additionally, Energy Accelerant no longer increases the base damage of Symmetry, Telesto, Black Talon, and Deathbringer. You could literally two-shot people with Symmetry, and Telesto was ridiculous. They let it ride for like 8 hours. It was pretty fun. Fixed an issue where the exotic catalyst for the sidearm Stasia 77k, whatever, was incorrectly accruing progress through energy weapon slot kills. Oh, well, damn. Didn't get that far, so I couldn't take advantage of that. I mean, I still have till Tuesday, but I probably still won't take advantage of that. That gun's like very gimmicky. It's fun, but it's not something I equipped every time I need, you know, a fun sidearm or anything like that. Vault of Glass, World's First, launches on Saturday. They got known issues here. This is getting fixed. Oh, it's giving people powerful gear instead of pinnacle. That explains a lot. I've done that like 4 times. I'll stop doing that now. Or just save your bounties. That's probably smarter, guys. Save your servitor bounties for next Tuesday. The empty tank loss sector is rewarding helmet exotic when leg exotics are advertised, which also sucks because I was trying to get those new boots. It's, you know, there's bugs here and there. It's not too bad. The launch was a little rocky of this season, but all in all, guys, I'm enjoying this season. That's it for the weekly update. Let me know what you guys think of this season in the comments below. Also, click the like button on this video because it does really help me out, and also subscribe to the channel to keep up to date on everything Destiny, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.